Yes, a very good afternoon. Right, so yesterday we first completed with company accounts and audit. Yes, then after that, a very small chapter on the liabilities of the auditor. Yes, liabilities of the auditor under the Companies Act and under the Income Tax Act. And under the Companies Act, we had two, the civil liabilities and the criminal liabilities. Under civil liabilities, we had the damages for negligence and the liability for misfeasance. And under criminal liabilities, the untrue statement in the prospectus or the false particulars or omission of a material fact. Right. Then after that, we started with the next chapter on audit committee and corporate governance. Yes, clause 49 of the listing agreement, which has given the code of corporate governance. And first requirement of the code is regarding the composition of the board of directors. What does it say? At least 50% non-executive directors, at least one woman director. And then depending upon the chairman, whether he is executive, non-executive, is he regular, not regular? If he is regular, is he a promoter or related to people one level below the board, or not a promoter and not related to people one level below the board? Accordingly, you need to decide one half independent directors or one third independent directors. So we said where it was NRNP. And a non-executive, regular, but not a promoter or not related to people one level below the board. In that case, it was one-third independent directors. In all the other three cases, it was one-half independent directors. Right. Yes. So now continuing further in this chapter, we need to first understand the definition of an independent director. Right. So we need to understand, yes, the definition of an independent director. Earlier, you know, only this clause 49 used to talk about an independent director. But now Companies Act 2013, even they have incorporated the term independent director. Right. So independent director, certainly the first condition is that he should be a non-executive director. Right. So first, so he has to be a non-executive director. So all independent directors are non-executive directors, but not necessary that all non-executive directors are independent directors. He is a non-executive director and a person of integrity, experience and reputation. Yes, person of integrity, experience, reputation. Then after that, he is not a promoter or is not related to people and managerial, people holding a managerial position. So not a promoter, has not been a promoter of the company for the last three financial years. Then after that, he has no pecuniary relationship with four companies: company, holding company, subsidiary company and associate company. Yes, pecuniary matlab monetary relationship apart from receiving the managerial remuneration. Has no pecuniary relationship with the company, the holding company, the subsidiary company and the associate company. Next one, relative does not have a material pecuniary relationship. Any relative can have a monetary relationship, but not a material pecuniary relationship. So relative does not have a material pecuniary relationship and age is not less than 21 years. Not less than 21 years of age. These are the first five conditions. A person of integrity, experience, not a promoter, has not been a promoter, has no pecuniary relationship, relative has no material pecuniary relationship and is not less than 21 years of age. Then after that, what are the other conditions? It says he neither by himself, neither by himself nor through his relatives. So neither by himself nor through his relatives, and under this now we have 5 points. Neither by himself nor through his relative has been an employee or a key managerial personnel again of the four companies, and a company, holding company, subsidiary company and associate company. Yes, has neither by himself nor through his relatives been an employee or a key managerial personnel of the company. Neither by himself nor through his relatives. Okay, you understand before all the 5 points, this is common. Neither by himself nor through his relatives. And under that, we have these 5 points. Are you getting? Neither by himself nor through his relatives has been an employee, partner, proprietor. Has been an employee, partner, proprietor. Yes, in the previous 3 years of the stat audit firm, of the company secretary firm and the cost audit firm. Has neither, huh? It's all not. Has not been an employee partner proprietor of the stat audit, company secretary, cost audit firm, or the legal firm, consulting firm, exceeding more than 10% of the gross receipts of the firm. So stat audit, company secretary, cost audit, so not at all allowed. And legal firm, consulting firm, not more than 10% of the gross receipts of those firms. Has not been an employee, partner, proprietor of these 5 firms. Has neither by himself nor through his relatives. Yani ke say last year tak you were a partner in PwC. You understand? And this year you want to become a director in Jio Limited. It says you cannot be an independent director. Why? Because you are a partner in PwC who are their statutory auditors. And now you want to become an independent director in Jio Limited. It says not possible. Then after that it says neither by himself nor through his relatives is holding more than 2% of the voting powers of the shares of the company. And a voting power of the shares of the company and a substantial shareholder not holding more than 2% of the block of voting shares. Not holding more than 2% of the block of voting shares, neither by himself nor through his relatives. Then neither by himself nor through his relatives is a chief executive director. Is a chief executive director of a non-profit organization. Is a chief executive director of a not-for-profit organization whose more than 25% receipts are coming from the 4 companies, company, holding, subsidiary, associate, or through the promoters or the directors. And then after that is neither by himself nor through his relatives is a material service provider, customer, lessor, lessee, supplier of the company. Yes, service provider, customer, lessor, lessee, supplier of the company. Yes, lessor, lessee, yes, supplier of the company. Neither by himself nor through his relatives. And these are the 5 points. Right, so these 5 points over here and these 5 points over here and plus one blanket condition, ke first thing he has to be a non-executive director. Then such a person is called to be an independent director. Right, so these are all the P points over here, no? And a person of integrity experience is not a promoter, has no pecuniary relationship, relative does not have a material pecuniary relationship. And then one extra point which you need to remember, 21 years of age. And here neither by himself nor through his relatives. And then you have to remember the 5 points. So I've divided it under 2 parts, na? The definition of independent director. One, the P points and the 21 point. You understand? Has not a person of integrity, not a promoter, no pecuniary relation, relative does not have a material pecuniary relationship. And over here, neither by himself nor through his relatives. Is an employee, key managerial personnel of the 4 companies, then neither by himself nor through his relatives is an employee partner proprietor of the 5 firms. Then after that, not holding more than 2% of the block of voting shares. Then after that, not a chief executive director of any non-profit organization whose more than 25% receipts are coming from those 4 companies and is not a material service provider, customer, lessor, lessee, customer, yes, supplier of the company. Does everybody get that? So does this match with the definition of independent director that you study in Companies Act? No, it is only for the company. 2% of the block of voting shares, I need to check, but as far as I remember, that's only for the company. Total more than 2% or more of the voting power of the company. So it's only of...